three-star grant into it and come up with a fire tanker for essentially no county money at all. But every one of those has to be approved by you before we can ever even apply. So the last time we asked, we were denied. We're more than happy to apply for it, but y'all have to offer it.
But there's a chance we won't get it, but we've got to have okay to even apply, but we might get it, we might not.
But I think the one you're talking about was the one who's talking about the Pony Grant, that they haven't even done the rules for it yet, so.
They haven't, yeah, they haven't promulgated the rules until the next legislative session.
Well, that state grant, Mark told me that they would be paying, but the 20%, that's where the, is where the county could pay that part. We could get the grant to the state, or Mark told me that they would pay the 20%, what the county would be out of that, is what the grant.
He didn't give me details, I can tell he wasn't near in degree to be able to share. At best, it'd be next year, where it's on the table, from the state, is what you're saying.
Yes.
Thank you.
So is this board in agreement on the final number, do you want to change any numbers, go through this by line?
I'm moving. What about your final number, that 93,567 is what you had last year, can you do the same thing this year on that? I mean, right now, it's cut down to 89,143.
Does anybody know how much size, that we're going to get the size? Size and answer.
I have to give it to the trustee.
But I can't hear the time to read it. That's really a true, the size, it's a long time anyway.
It's like a motion to approve 54,310, fire prevention and control, estimated $111,493. Do I have a second?
Second.
Any other discussion? Call roll.
Russell Reed.
Yes.
Corey Davenport.
I'm going to vote no, because I don't want to cut it.
Karen Ashford.
I'm somewhere for you, I don't want to, that they're struggling and doing good to buy the turnouts at the end, I'm going to vote no.
Jim Bush.
I'm staying.
Greg Mitchell.
Yes.
Brent Brandon.
No.
Randy Gannon.
Yes.
Kim Davenport.
Yes.
Ronnie Mahaffey.
Yes.
Seven, five.
5-3-1. We're going to.
What?
Okay, what are we going to increase on?
I'm not asking for an increase as much as I am just saying that I don't cut something, I think they should at least get what they asked for, and we're not, we haven't cut anybody else.
I'd like to motion, we have a second deadline, plus that $22,350.
So we move, we'll just go down the line, so.
I haven't been up so much, so they really.
If you want to give them what they asked for, or what they asked for, or what they spent.
$94,325, what they asked for, plus 23.
About 2016, 675.
23.
So it's $116,000.
$670,000.
That's my mom.
Motion is to, you know which one to keep track of, which one of Collins thing? Which one of these Collins will change?
Which one?
Which one? So we just do, figure it like it was last year.
Okay. All right. Call Rob.
Do we have a second?
What do we, that one, huh? Do we have a second?
Yeah, I'll say.
What we second in first? We're going, we're moving the bottom line of $54,310 to $116,675.
Which would be the same amount of money that last year, plus the 23, or 22,350 that we moved.
Utility.
The utilities, but that's changed. That's a big quality, right?
Any other, so I have.
Aren't you gonna have to put the money somewhere in these, where?
I'll go back to the same here, but this.
Essentially, it's last year's budget plus $22,350, line $452. Last year's budget plus $22,350.
But that $22,350 is moving out of county buildings.
Out of $54,000.
Yeah, so it's not like they're getting any more money. We're just moving that.
Just to separate.
Just to separate their utility.
So I have a motion. I have a second.
Yeah, I'll say.
You got that? Motion is second. Okay, call Rob.
Russell Reed.
Yes.
Corey Davenport.
Yes.
Karen Ashford.
Yes.
Jim Bush.
The reason why I stayed last time, the household budget is to win. It's like a home. Now, you can keep spending money, but, you know, like a homeowner, I don't live in a tent either. I vote no.
Greg Mitchell.
Yes.
Brent Brandon.
Yes.
Randy Gans.
Yes.
Kim Davenport.
No.
Ronnie Mahaffey.
No.
$643 against.
$116,675.
Before we go on to our next item, based on what Mr. Mahaffey said, I think the county attorney needs to send a co-op, kind of, we spread. From their perspective, it's been squared away. We're still doing some research to see if we can't go back and collect. If they claim the tax years are closed and therefore they're not going back beyond 2018. So as far as co-op, they're done, we're pursuing to see if that is correct from a state and federal standpoint. We're trying to collect more. Maybe for it.
What's that, Diane?
Well, I just have to visit and get a check from A and G, and I got the email back.
Go ahead, Russell.
How many dollars are we referring to? Let me change that. How many dollars are we getting first? And how many dollars were we cheated out of? So, any idea?
Multiple years.
I'll just tell you the information that I have, which is very incomplete because it never could be nailed down. Diane and Brent, if I say something that's incorrect, if you understand, please correct it. But the information that I got, speaking to the lady that, I use the terminology, doing the books, handling the books or whatever. I can tell, I was on the phone, she was trying to go back through the file. Based on my question, very simple, when's the last time you showed you made the payment to us? And she just made this statement. I see here where payment of credit was given to the Woodbury City Water Department in 2004. She wasn't answering the question directly, she was just showing what she put her hands on in the file. Talking directly with Mr. Henderson,
Rick Anderson?
Yes.
John.
They did give us 18, based on their calculations, which I had to go back, double check this for us. $17,000, $18,000, somewhere in that neighborhood. So they gave it to us in three checks, one for the ambulance, one for the county, what was the other one? Or the day grant. Two checks in three. Couldn't think of one for sure. Okay, I think it was 30, somewhere in the neighborhood of $18,000, or for 18. And maybe confused 2018 with $18,000, maybe $17,000, but yeah, I'm close. And that was it before they were concerned.
So you made the check?
Here we are.
He, I don't know what changed. He made the check to see how much tax money he got from January to June. And then from July 1 to December. Because in July, the gas and diesel taxes went up a few cents. Of that year. And he should have done it again this year, I think, for the last time, for the improved that. And we're getting up close to 60 cents a gallon on diesel. Road tax. And they're fixing a gallon of gas.
Again, I did not attempt to in any way reconcile the checks to the amount, I'm just too disappointed in where we stood. What appeared to be their standpoint, their conclusion of the matter. But I believe even last year, also, I don't know how they determined, but they threw it out. Something like 44 cents a gallon, isn't it?
Yeah, but I'd say it's.
I know what you're saying, yes, sir. I read that.
And there's al, and there's also a list of taxes, federal tax, the state tax, a bus tax, and a Tennessee special environmental tax. Add to that. And you might want to look into, see if the co-op was charged a fuel delivery tax. Or just hauling it out here to. That's all I got on.
Could you help look into that, Mr. Russell?
One thing I can do is take the gas bill and sit down and add up the taxes and see if it can, one thing I can do.
Appreciate that. We'll do the best we can to kind of nail that down. And a lot of people, Chris, myself, Ronnie, and Diane, met with Mr. Henderson, tried to nail down what they owe us based on the fact that somehow we, again, their side, was we didn't turn in some, we're a non-taxed, we're a tax-free entity. And so, again, we try to correct it as best we can, and we'll go back so far. Now, what I have here, just to kind of for administrative purposes, make sure we're tracking before we leave, I think the general fund, I think that we have not went through, did not pass the election commission and the sheriff's office. Anybody else tracking anything that?
Passed the election.
I just want to make sure our notes are good.
I don't think we took a vote on.
I know we're looking back into it.
Yeah, that's why I'm waiting.
I have no vote.
You're right.
It's not that election, right?
So.
So what do you want to vote on?
So I have one. 51,500. New printed document today, I have the same bottom number of 166,514, and the old document, 166,514.
I will.
Have a discussion.
Now, this question, he is not taking the county health insurance? Okay, that's fine, I'm just making a personal note.
Brandon, did that contact you today?
He did.
His board hasn't approved this.
Right, his board has not approved this budget.
So we need wait on his board to approve the four wishes. Is that what I'm understanding then? Okay.
So, back to the sheriff's department.
I really hate to put y'all off, but we knocked out some of the things that we turned out that must not first be over.
Sure. I think that's the only thing, I think we've covered everything in the general line.
Pass number one and EMS.
If I'm missing the county clerk's office, where is that? The county clerk's office, where is it?
I've got.
Page 16.
16.
Is there $25,000 in there?
Yes. 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 See, I thought that already passed the county clerk's office. Yeah, it's already there, very bottom, line 790, $25,000.
Well, maybe that's the salary.
See, that's what I was wondering, how you say it.
I think it's 460.
Thank you, Mayor, that's really what it is.
Let me look at it, $2,000.
It's making sure.
$7,000.
We're all on the same page.
And then, okay, the new document here is, it's moving.
Yep.
Because I had a factor in it that had been put in at $25,000.
Line 161 was $52,000, 161 in the new budget is $74,700.
And then she's got the money to do her computers and stuff, but money she got in litigation taxes.
I already have my new computers, they didn't cost us one dime.
So. It's on page, on the new budget that we passed out, it's on line 161, secretary line.
Okay.
It moved from $52,000 to $74,700.
Looking wrong.
What'd you say, Karen, you wanted to go to?
Well, we have a pass number one or EMS.
No, they just start on page 23 with the.
What page?
Yeah, page 23, get to see 700. That's a good number on the back.
You talked about $56,700, parks and fair board community, cash contribution $15,600. This is the total, yeah, I guess, the previous page is zeroed out. That's the, what we zeroed out, zeroed out. Okay. All right, discussion, $57,600.
I had actually decreased that $499 down to $500, but y'all said at least $2,500. That's cool.
Well, we're pulling it up, we're using the money already for chemicals.
Right.
Who's doing the cleanup, so since we don't have a supervisor over that area?
Well, the contract has some limited cleanup, mostly ground speakers, hydro fisher. Talking about cleaning up the pool area.
What, all the community center in general?
Well, the community, we mow the community center in general, grass and stuff like that, and maintain it. Some of the, we do have some, we've got to work a little bit better with the contract to get some of the trash out of the pool area. That's kind of a growth project. We essentially ran it on a shoestring with some. Played lifeguards out of the fees. Paid for the chemicals, paid for the water, pay for the electricity bill, but the labor, it's all inmate labor, it'll be inmate labor when we shut it down here, it's a deal about the money.
Is this a assistance and supervisor, or is that what it's there?
Right. What line?
5670103105.
We don't have those. Well, we have zero, not out. That's what I'm saying, that part was zeroed out, we're taking care of internally with grants, money. What was it written for, that's a little.
So we got 15.6, and just a heads up, if we had some money coming in from the horse shop and stuff, we could go in there.
We'd have to, well, yes, we put it in the trustee, we have a revenue.
Do we have any kind of revenue flow in there, do you know of?
No.
So we haven't had any kind of anything coming in there?
Yeah, the arena we have.
What'd you say?
Arena, I thought you meant the pool.
No, I don't know.
The pool doesn't have any revenue flow, it's just basically, it's got the pay in and pay out, essentially, all the revenue so far is just paid for lifeguards pretty much, and some managerial fees from contractor, that's pretty much it. Now, the horse arena, we do have some money coming in from the horse arena, we got some deposits, we've had to use some inmate labor to clean up grounds over there. And we've done a little bit more work over at the ball field this summer, so like I said, as long as inmate labor is available, we can kind of continue to work with the sheriff's department, and have enough guys to kind of supervise them, we can win a bit from that.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
There's nothing different from what we've ever done. I mean, there's still, here's the motion I've got. All for profits will pay $250 fairground fee, user fee, and a $250 refundable cleaning fee. The cleaning fee will be returned upon cleaning of the facility, and all rentals for profit and nonprofit will pay a $50 home fee. So what we actually voted on, the child actually voted against, increased the amount of money we charge. It didn't decrease, it didn't increase.
Missed that somewhere, say that one more time, because it doesn't sound right.
Here's the actual thing that we voted on. Commissioner Greg Beach will make a motion to exempt all nonprofit organizations from the fairground user fee, but charge the refundable cleaning fee to be returned after cleaning. All for profits will pay the $250 fairground user fee and a $250 refundable cleaning fee. Cleaning fees will be returned upon cleaning of the facility. All rentals, for profit and nonprofit, will pay a $50 home fee. So if you're a church and you want to hold a fundraiser up there to pay off your van, we charge you $250, because that is a for-profit event. Plus a $50 home fee.
But a church is a nonprofit, is what I'm saying.
No, if the event is a nonprofit, it has nothing to do with the organization. If you want to go up there and hold a birthday party, and you're not making no money on it, we're not going to charge you. But if you're going up there to make a profit to pay off the van, and you're a church, then you get charged $250. I mean, it's the same exact thing we've always had. Greg actually increased it by $50 to charge them a monthly fee. And I got this from Lynn, by the way. So that's in the official record. So I just want to clarify that.
Well, like I said, the only thing we've done different this summer, we opened the pool about a month later, and we planned, we went over there and spent a lot of man hours with the pool. We mowed some of the inside of the ball fields. We picked up trash, we fixed a few fences, we collected what money we're required to collect. Horse arena, the biggest expense over there is utilities. Electric bill, water bill, it costs money to, I think, during the fair, we're looking at least $600 electric bill, two different sources.
Somebody built us on that.
Well, they probably used an outlet that we didn't know about, so. manage the fair, really the local group, nonprofit group, manage the fair. We have a lot of county went to their planning meetings. So, again, I think we can run it on 15-6.
We'll do. Very thanks. Greatly appreciate it. I think a lot of people responded to that very well. Have loved the idea of it being back up.
Thank Brian's. Yeah, they took it on.
Very good of them, and I'm glad to see the end of it.
I second. So I've got a motion. 56,700, Parks and Fair Boards, Community Center, $15,600. You got any more discussion? You got a motion to second. Any more discussion? Call the roll.
Russell Reed.
Yes.
Corey Davenport.
Yes.
Karen Ashford.
Yes.
Jim Bush.
Yes.
Gary Mitchell.
Yes.
Brent Brandon.
Yes.
Randy Dennis.
Yes.
Ken Davenport.
Yes.
Ronnie Mahan.
Yes.
Agricultural Extension Office.
There's only one increase in it, is that one of his employees took insurance.
And that's the 57,100, and the 70,722.
Their salaries are the exact same as last year, because they'll tell me to go back to last year's salary. So they did ask for an increase, but it's not. The only increase is the utilities, which I moved to 51,800.
One of them had a step up in her, and that was increasing salary.
But they did, but the increase is not in here, not what they asked for.
How much was her increase?
So the salary they asked for was 46,793, and the benefits was 26,27.
Run the call for the end, Ray, Diane.
46,793 for the salary, 20,627 for benefits.
I'll make a motion to approve 57,100 Agricultural Extension Office for, what's the bottom line? Of $70,722.
I have a second.
Second.
Got any other discussion? Call the roll.
Russell Reed.
Yes.
Corey Davenport.
Yes.
Karen Ashford.
Yes.
Jim Bush.
Yes.
Greg Mitchell.
Yes.
Brent Brandon.
Yes.
Randy Dennis.
That includes the step up and all.
No.
It does?
No.
Ken Davenport.
No.
Ronnie Mahaffey.
Yes.
All right, next. Now, I do know now, 58,300 on my paper, I don't know where that went to, but I do think there was a request for some money to go into that. I don't have it in front of me.
$12,498, you might as well say $12,500.
Veteran Service Office.
That's a day, really, not $12,500. What? That's all.
All right, any other discussion concerning the Veteran Service Office? That would be new money.
I know everybody wants, I work at the VA, and I'm just glad, just to let everybody know. It takes me maybe 30 minutes to drive to Murfreesboro. If any veteran ever needs to go to Murfreesboro, all they have to do is call one of the Upper Cumberland vans. They drive right down there. Your got many, many people that are waiting right down there. In other words, 20 miles away, not even 20 miles, whatever it is, 30 minutes away, and very knowledgeable